Okay, so good morning, everybody. Well, today I'm going to discuss a capsule lecture on industrial markets. And in the last class, if I remember, we discussed about the consumer markets. And consumer markets were more concerned with the products which are directly consumed by the consumer. And in case of industrial markets, we deal with those products which are used by the companies for further processing or production of the other products. So business organization actually deal with both sale and purchase of the products, and there are these industrial markets that consist of all the companies that acquire goods and services that we use in the production of the other products. They can be sold, rented, they can be supplied, they can be given for any further form of processing of the product. Example of these industries include manufacturing, like we make cars. So for making cars, we need nuts and bolts, we need tire, we need a steel body. For making phone, we need the SIM card, the whole structure of the phone, and the other things. So these other things basically come in the industrial market. Then we include services as well, because in services also we may use services of logistic providers that are not the main providers of the main product, but rather they are the providers of the subsets or the sub products of the main product. So there is indeed a high competition in this market, and there are these top challenges that these companies often face, because they have to keep the market very active, because they have a lot of high competition, and most of the companies are vying for more attention. So the challenges include, they have to have a very deep understanding of the customers, what companies are looking for, how much volume they are willing to buy, and at what price they are willing to buy. Identifying the new opportunities, that can always increase or decrease with time to come, as and when the consumer demands change. They also have to improve the value of the management techniques. They have to calculate the better marketing performance and accountability metrics. They also have to compete on and off basis with the global countries as well. Countering the threat of the product and service commoditization by bringing innovative offerings to the market is very fast. So they have to act and react very fast with respect to these changes. There are these differences that we often see between the industrial market and the consumer market. The very first is the fewer, but there are large number of buyers. There is often very close supplier and customer relationship. And then they normally have very professional purchasing. So we will see companies buying in bulk. They will have very set standard price at which products are sold. Normally the contracts are there for 1 or more years. There are multiple buying influences, and there are multiple sales calls as well. We often have a derived demand from this case, that is a demand for the business good is ultimately derived from the demand of the consumer good. That means if there is a demand for car only, then there will be the demand of tire and the other accessories. It is basically inelastic demand, that is the total demand for many business goods is inelastic, that is, it is not much affected by the price changes. For example, even if the price of tire changes very high, we still be needing that tire to make a complete car. Similarly, for a mobile phone, if the SIM card prices increase or decrease, that will not affect their demand, because in any case, we would be needing SIM card to complete the phone. So often we have fluctuating demand as well. The demand for business goods and services tend to be more volatile in nature. Geographically, there are concentrated buyers for this, because it is not a necessity that we are going to buy only from one country. Wherever we are getting price at a very competitive rate, at affordable rate, we prefer to go and buy from these countries. Now, we must have seen that a lot of countries are looking to India to buy quality raw material, which is available at a very effective cost. We often have direct purchasing, because business buyers normally directly buy from the manufacturers rather than through the intermediaries. In the industrial markets, we normally have three buying situations that happen, and three buying situations are modified rebuy, new task, or it can be a straight rebuy as well. In straight rebuy, what we do, the purchasing department reorders supplies such as office supplies, and the supplier then will make an effort to maintain the product. In the modified rebuy, what happens, the buyer in a modified rebuy wants to change the product specification, and then wants to then supply the products. In a new task, the new task purchaser will buy a product, and then the greater the cost or a risk, a larger will be the number of the participants. Then we also have, we see that business marketers are also recognizing the importance of their brand and how they must execute well in a number of areas to gain marketplace. Because when there is more competition, indeed, they will have to figure out the new, unique, innovative policy that will set them apart from the other manufacturers. We also have a system buying and selling process where there is a proper system which we follow in case of industrial goods. For example, we may go for solicited bids, or we may go for proper contracts which are quite lengthy and quite complex in nature. Now, these particular things we do not see in case of the consumer market. There are certain actors that we have in the business buying process, and these actors include initiators, users, influencers, deciders, buyers, and approvers. Users are those people who will actually use the product or a service. Users initiate the business proposal, and they actually help define the product requirement. On the other hand, deciders are those people who decide on the product requirement or the supplier. For example, they're going to mention the product specifications. They're also going to mention the cost or the volume that is required in a particular company. Then we have approvers as well. These are those people who authorize the proposed action of deciders and the buyer. So these are normally the people at the top level, maybe senior purchase manager, senior procurement manager, who will ultimately approve the purchase of these products. Initiators are those people who request that something has to be purchased. So it could be any department that has a need for that particular product. Deciders are again who decide on a product requirement. Buyers are those people who ultimately have the formal authority to select the supplier and arrange for the purchase. Then we also have gatekeepers. These are those people who have the power to prevent sellers or information from reaching members of the buying center. So there are these actors that play quite a very active role in the industrial market. Business buyers also have a personal motivation, perception, and preferences, because irrespective of the age and income, I suppose, it will not vary. What will vary is the requirement of the product to make the final product. Then further, we also have like target marketing firms and buying centers. So often what happens, the successful business firms, what they do, they require the business markets know which type of companies to focus on. For example, I think every manufacturing company will have their own criteria from which company to procure the product, and how much to procure, and how much order they have to give to which company. So like this, they have to target these companies and identify them, and then accordingly purchase from them. And further, we also have to talk about the things like a business marketer is not likely to know exactly what kind of dynamics actually work in the environment or in the decision process. Although whatever information we can obtain about the personalities and interpersonal factors is always useful, but I think the more focus will be on the product rather than on the personality of a consumer. We also follow a certain process for purchase and procurement, and the process starts with basically identification of a need or identification of a problem, that what is that one thing that we're looking for. So if I'm wanting to buy accessories for the car, so the need is accessories for the car. So only when I have the accessories, then my car will be complete. After problem recognition, we actually have to describe the product with respect to the specifications. So if I say that I need an engine, so I say that what should be the specifications of that particular product, which will fit my final product. Then accordingly, I search for the supplier who can actually supply me those raw materials with the set specifications. And these specifications, I'm sure they will vary from product to product. They can't be same. These specifications with respect to the height, width, the color, or maybe the weight also, right? And they specify these in advance, and then they search for the suppliers who can actually supply them these required products. Again, they may use the catalogs, vertical markets are there, pure play auction sites are there, where they can easily find the suppliers that can supply these material. They can also go for e-procurement, wherein there are websites that are organized around the two types of e-hubs, vertical and the horizontal. So in the vertical hubs, they are centered around the industries like plastic, steel. Functional hubs, that is the second type, is surrounded around the logistic, media, buying and advertising. Then we have proposal solicitation, supply selection, and then ultimately we go for the purchase of a particular product. Then there are order and routine specifications. We review the performance, whether they are able to supply on time or not, whether they are maintaining the quality or not. And depending on that, on annual basis, we review their performance and then we go further for giving the contract the second time to the same company. Then in this case, we also have these eight categories that are very important when it comes to understanding the relationships of buyer and supplier. So we need basic buying and selling. These are simple routine exchanges, bare bones. These relationships require more adaptation. Contractual transaction, these exchanges are defined by formal contract. Customer supply, in this traditional custom supply situation, there is competition rather than cooperation. Cooperative system, we'll see more cooperation in this, and collaborative, we will normally find suppliers working in collaboration with each other. So that was all that we did in this particular chapter that I wanted to cover in the capsule lecture series. Apart from the other variables, the new variable is risks and opportunism. So when we are dealing with only one kind of a supplier, well, it might be very risky, because in future, if that supplier goes bankrupt or something happens in that company, well, the whole supply chain will get affected. So we have to select the suppliers in such a manner that the continuity will not be affected. Like recently in the pandemic time, all the countries that were dependent on one particular regional area, for example, like China, they must have faced a lot of shortage of the different products that they were importing from such regions. So we have to see that dependency, and we have to review the performance of these companies from these countries that are able to supply in the future or not. Then we also need to keep a tab on the emerging supplies from the other areas. So I think there is a need for the continuous research that we need to find out what are the other countries, what are the other suppliers that are there and that can supply our need in order to make our product. So institutional market consists of schools, hospitals, nursing homes, prisons, and other institutions that must provide goods and services to the people in their care. That was all that we covered in a very short manner. We'll be back with a new chapter. Till then, please keep on studying and keep on watching. Thank you so much.